Hello and welcome to Bobcat Update. I'm Desiree Martinez. Today we'll tell you some good news about gas prices.
And I'm Chelsea Smith. We'll also take a look at why Texas State students are having problems at the San Antonio bus stop. A falling aquifer level is triggering a stage one water restriction in San Marcos. The Edwards Aquifer continues to decline due to insufficient rain and high aquifer demands. San Marcos officials released a statement yesterday saying even though we have experienced good rainfall in the winter and spring, it hasn't been enough to help the Edwards Aquifer recover from nearly 2 years of extreme drought conditions. Stage 1 limits lawn watering to once a week on designated days. The Stage 1 water restriction will go into effect on Monday.
April marks the start of the wildfire season in Texas, and residents are urged to prepare early. Preventative measures should be taken, such as removing combustible materials and picking up trash. Officials say burn bans will be enforced. They want to avoid a repeat of last year's disastrous fires that claimed thousands of acres and several homes. To survive a wildfire, plan in advance, know what your evacuation route will be, and keep important supplies handy in case you have to leave at a moment's notice. Texas State commuters are encountering several problems at a bus stop in San Antonio. Connie Gonzalez has more in this Bobcat Update.
Some of those who ride the Texas State Shuttle to and from San Antonio are dissatisfied with the service.
To ride the Texas State Shuttle, commuters have to park at the Via Randolph parking lot, then cross this busy intersection to wait for the bus. The bus stop is not marked in any way, so it makes it especially difficult for first-time riders to find. When we asked where the bus stop was, the information desk said it's right next to this XXX bar.
Well, I didn't even know this was the location. It took me a couple minutes to figure out that the bus stop was over here on the right side of me.
It's a little scary. I feel like before it used to be back there where there was a bar, and now they recently moved it over here, but it's not safe, and like crossing the street to go to another side, I don't think it's a safe location.
Via started encountering problems with the students using its lot because Via riders are having a difficult time finding parking spaces. The Texas State Shuttle System has not reached an official agreement with Via to resolve the issue. Many students say the city should put a crosswalk in that area so they can safely cross the street. For Bobcat Update, I'm Connie Gonzalez.
Gas prices have dropped for the third straight day. AAA reports the average price for a gallon of regular is down to $3.89. Gas prices are mirroring crude oil prices. The Lundberg survey says if crude prices hold steady, gas prices may have already peaked. It costs the least to get around in Wyoming, where gas prices are about $3.64 a gallon. Hawaii has the most expensive gas at $4.61.
Construction on Cheatham Street near the San Marcos River is ongoing. Several streets in the neighborhood are affected. The project to improve underground water systems was started in May 2010 and was supposed to be completed this month. However, it'll now likely continue through at least August. The construction forces customers of businesses in the area to take alternate routes.
Texas police are charging a Houston woman with capital murder. Verna McLean shot Kayla Schuchart outside a doctor's office on Tuesday. Schuchart was taking her newborn for his three-day-old checkup. The San Antonio Express reports that McLean, a registered nurse, shot Schuchart multiple times in the chest, placed the baby in her car, and sped off, leaving the new mother mortally wounded. The child was recovered several hours later and will be soon reunited with his father. McLean is being held in Montgomery County Jail without bail.
Several masked gunmen opened fire this morning at a cockfighting match in southern Texas, killing three people and injuring eight more. The Hidalgo County Sheriff says the shootings caused bedlam at a ranch that housed a sophisticated cockfighting operation that even had concession stands and bleachers for the spectators. The shooting occurred in La Blanca near McAllen.
19 years ago today, a 51-day standoff at a religious cult compound in Waco, Texas, came to a tragic end. On April 19, 1993, fire started at the Branch Davidian site near Waco, Texas, as federal agents raided the building. At least 76 followers of cult leader David Koresh died in the ensuing fire, including Koresh himself. Four federal agents were also killed. The disaster followed weeks of confrontations between Branch Davidians and agents with the FBI and the ATF.
When we get back, we'll show how the movie Spotlight is shining in Central Texas.
And Desiree will have your entertainment update. Stay tuned.
Mm-hmm.
Crime Stoppers.
Stopping crime is every citizen's responsibility. So remember that the eyes of the Texas State Bobcats are upon you. If you have any information on a crime, call Crime Stoppers at 512-245-STOP. Call, leave your tip, and remain completely anonymous. That's 512-245-7867.
Welcome back to Bobcat Update. We'll now go to Desiree Martinez with your entertainment update.
Austin is looking more and more like Hollywood these days as the city continues to grow into a celebrity hotspot. Stars of the new movie Get the Gringo walked for the red carpet at the premiere screening at the Alamo Draft House last night. Cast members Mel Gibson, Kevin Hernandez, director Adrian Grunberg, and fellow director Robert Rodriguez were all present. The film follows Gibson as an American career criminal who is captured by Mexican authorities and taken to a rough and tough prison. Grunberg makes his debut as a movie director in this action-packed dark comedy that will begin showing exclusively on DirecTV May 1st. The Lucky One is now in movie theaters nationwide. It's based on a best-selling book by Nicholas Sparks. Zac Efron plays a Marine back from the battlefield on a mission to fulfill a promise. He needs to find the woman he believes was his good luck charm during the war. The Lucky One is rated PG-13. The lineup for this year's Cannes Film Festival was released today. Stars like Angelina Jolie, Brad Pitt, Kristen Stewart, and Reese Witherspoon are expected to attend the 65th annual event. Houstonian director Wes Anderson grabbed the opening presentation with his film Moonrise Kingdom. The festival will be held May 16th through the 27th in France. The entertainment industry is paying tribute to longtime show host and entrepreneur Dick Clark. Clark died yesterday at the age of 82. He was perhaps best known for his music series, American Bandstand, but he also hosted game shows and blooper shows. For the past 40 years, he was the man who counted down as the ball dropped at Times Square, ushering in a new year. Clark most recently did that 4 months ago. Yesterday, he died of a heart attack. Reality star Kim Kardashian is throwing in her hat in the political ring. Kim says she's going to run for mayor of Glendale, California. In an unaired clip from E's Khloe and Lamar, Kim tells her sister she plans to purchase a home in Glendale and run for office in about 5 years. She's apparently called on a friend to help her legitimize her forthcoming campaign. Why Glendale? Kim says it's an Armenian town, a nod to the Kardashian family's heritage. The search for replacement for Hunger Games director Gary Ross is narrowing. Catching Fire, the next movie in the popular series, will have one of two directors: Bennett Miller, who directed Moneyball, or Francis Lawrence, who is best known for I Am Legend. Lawrence is said to be the likely winner due to his availability. Catching Fire is set to be released in November of next year. Dwayne The Rock Johnson is getting in the ring of reality TV. The professional wrestler turned actor is set to star in a new reality show called The Hero. Fans will help determine the fate of the contestants entirely through social media and on-screen decision-making. Johnson is one of the co-producers of the show. That's all for today's entertainment news. When we get back, we'll tell you how Bobcats are preparing for finals. Stay right there.
The number of bike riders on the Texas State campus is continuously growing. In an effort to ensure the safety of riders, Texas State offers assistance with all your bike needs. The Bike Cave, located in the Colorado Building, can help with repairs to your bike and even has bikes for sale. For more information, head on over to The Bike Cave or visit thebikecave.org.
Financially struggling homeowners may soon have another option besides foreclosure. The Federal Housing Finance Agency is enacting new guidelines that could help homeowners and banks. The agency will require lenders to make a final decision about whether to allow the sale within 60 days. In a short sale, the bank that holds the mortgage must agree to accept a price for a home that's less than what the homeowner still owes. It will help homeowners who are desperate to get rid of the property. The new rules will go into effect June 1st.
A new NASA outreach project will enlist the help of amateur astronomers to discover near-Earth objects, or as NASA calls them, NEOs. NEOs are asteroids with orbits that occasionally bring them close to the Earth. NASA yesterday launched a new citizen science project called Target Asteroids. Its basic purpose is to improve the scientific understanding of these objects above us. Amateur astronomers will help better characterize the population of NEOs, including their position, motion, rotation, and changes in the intensity of light they emit.
The Texas State football team faces many challenges this year as it prepares to move into the Western Athletic Conference. And as Zach Kaditz tells us in this Bobcat update, one of those challenges is boosting attendance at home games.
The Football Bowl subdivision requires that institutions average at least 15,000 in actual or paid attendance for home football games during a rolling two-year period. The Bobcats averaged close to 13,000 2 years ago and a little over 15,000 last year for each home game. Joe Verschuren, director of ticket sales and operations, says he does not see the attendance requirement being an issue.
I don't think it's as much of a concern for us going into this year as it has been in the past. We expect to have at least 30,000 people at the first game of the season, and of course more than 15,000 of course for the rest of the games.
Texas State is doing a number of things to fill the newly updated 30,000 seat stadium, including sending out a mailer to 12,000 people who are associated with the university in some sort of way.
We'll try to reach as many people as we can to help promote everything that's going on with the new stadium, playing Texas Tech in the first game, our first season, playing in the WAC, so a lot for people to be excited about.
Getting students to be passionate about Texas State football has been a major issue for the university in the past. Verschuren says while the university is working with students to promote the games more, it is on the students to follow through.
It's got to be, you know, students helping to encourage other students. Hey, we go to Texas State, we're all in this together. And, you know, we need to be prideful about the direction that our university is going in.
Season tickets are now on sale for the upcoming season. For Bobcat Update, I'm Zach Kaditz.
There's one playoff spot left, and the Houston Rockets seem to be blowing their chance to get it. The NBA season is winding down, and the Rockets are winding down with it. They've now lost five straight games. Last night, they fell to cross-state rivals Dallas 117-110. Dirk Nowitzki led the way for the Mavericks, scoring 35 points, 31 of those in the second half. The Rockets are now in ninth place, and only four games are left in the regular season. Next up, Houston plays New Orleans tonight, and Dallas plays Golden State on Friday.
The women's basketball coach at the University of Tennessee is stepping down. Pat Summitt had guided the team for 38 seasons, netting eight NCAA championships along the way. She leads all coaches in victories. Her Lady Vols team won 1,098 games for her. Summitt was diagnosed last year with the early stages of Alzheimer's disease. Associate head coach Holly Warlick has been named Summitt's successor.
The Texas State baseball team is now on a six-game losing streak. In its most recent game, the men's team lost to the Longhorns for the 13th straight time. The loss also marked the end of an eight-game road trip during which the Bobcats had a 2-6 record. The Bobcats return home for a three-game series against Central Arkansas this weekend. The Cats have 17 games left this season and are 20-16 overall, 8-10 in the Southland Conference.
Texas State students strapped on their running shoes Saturday morning to race their way to a good cause. Monica Ramos has more in this Bobcat update.
ProRec teamed up for the first time with the Hayes County Food Bank to sponsor the Feed the Need 5K.
Excited to do this one because we've looped up with any charity before. We wanted to help benefit someone, and especially someone in a local area, so we looped up with the Hayes County Bank. This is the first time we've ever looped up with them.
Although it was her first time participating in Feed the Need, Texas State senior Kristen Buechler said it's a good way to make a difference.
I decided to run because it is for the Hayes County Food Bank, which does affect the county that I live in, and I just thought it was a great opportunity and a charity event to do what I like to do, and I like to run.
For Bobcat Update, I'm Monica Ramos.
Semester is coming to a close at Texas State University, and some students are already getting ready for final exams. The library is a popular place for last-minute cramming. The Student Learning Center is available prior to the exams to help students with any questions they might have. The instructors at SLAC can help from a variety of subjects, from accounting to Spanish. The final exam schedule should be found on the registrar's website.
Start off by just breaking it down.
Are you ready for final exams, Desiree?
I am. Luckily, this semester I don't really have a lot, and then it's graduation. So, what about you, Chelsea?
I have 4 final exams, and then I get to look forward to another 4 next semester before I graduate.
You better study. That's all for this edition of Bobcat Update.
We'll see you next time.